So your boys, Real Madrid, as the society would say, Real Madrid. So basically, Ramos. Do you really want to sell Ramos? Because here's my thing, because Real Madrid have to look at the scenario, because Perez, don't get too cute. Because I still believe you shouldn't have sold Cristiano. Shouldn't have sold Cristiano. Although I respect Real Madrid's stance in that instance, in the sense of, we're not Barcelona. There is no player that is bigger than the club, and no player can hold this club hostage. So I do sort of respect that sentiment. But for me, being realistic and keeping his football, how do you lose a guy who scored more goals than games he played in for you during his time at the club? That's insane. But with Ramos, my thing here is this. I get that he's getting old. I get that he's not the kind of player that he wants, specifically through that three-peat run. But my thing is, okay, you sell Ramos and Varane and Militao. You see, if let's say you were taking Ramos away and you already had a top-tier defender with you, whether it's a Van Dijk, whether it's a Koulibaly, whether it's a Skriniar, whether it's a De Vrij or so forth, working with Varane, okay, I get it. But we've seen what Real Madrid looked like without Ramos. We've seen what Real Madrid look like with Militao and Varane. And it is nightmare on Elm Street. You know, these guys get open themselves off like a new brothel. So that's what they, but the scenario here is that they want to keep him. They want to keep Ramos. But they say, look, because of your age, we don't want to give you. So Ramos wants 2 years. Ramos wants to stay. But Madrid only want to give him one more year. And they want to then assess things after that 1 year rather than committing to 2 years. Which does make sense. See, it makes sense. In a regular world, it makes sense. Since that's all, let's just do 1 year review. 1 year review, 1 year review. But my thing though is that for Real Madrid, if you lose Ramos, who do you have? Do you have certainties that we will get Koulibaly? We'll get Upamecano, who looks a bit shaky right now. Or we'll get a De Vrij or a Skriniar. You know, because if you are letting Ramos go and you're putting your faith in Varane and Militao, knowing the kind of tactic that Zidane plays and the kind of highlighting that Zidane plays, and you know Zidane is not going to change that way of play. For me, that's it's a bad move. For me, if you don't have a proper defender who can play that highline effectively, waiting in the wings, you keep Ramos for 2 years until you do. Because if you let Ramos go and you keep with Varane and Militao, Real Madrid are going to be pimp slaps. Now, if there's a different manager that comes in and makes Real Madrid a lot more pragmatic and changes their formation, changes their stance, and offers a bit more protection for those dudes, okay, then we can talk. But from last I checked, I don't think that is the scenario that is coming through. So from what we gather, it's Varane and Militao without Highline if Ramos leaves. So my advice is, who cares how old he is? He's still playing at a high level. Pay him the money. Give him the money. Give him those 2 years. Because you are not in a position and you do not have the luxury to be like, you're too old. We ain't going to ride with you, man. Because you just don't have the proper defensive cover with you. So, what do you guys think? Do you think that Real Madrid should stay and keep Ramos? Or do you think that they should allow him to go, that they can survive without Sergio Ramos? Guys, remember to check out my other channel, the Half Up Soft, my other YouTube channel. And also remember to head to the website, official website, halfupfootballhot.com for daily updates. Remember to like that vid. And also remember to subscribe to Football Hot for that daily football content crack. Peace out.